Good day, everyone. So today I will teach you about Unit 5, the marketing lah. Okay, so this is the learning outcome. Okay, so what is marketing? So marketing is a process of giving information to influence the customer thought and action of a product and service lah. So remember this, the definition of marketing. So the reason for marketing is to introduce a new brand. Okay, for example, your company, what is your brand name? Okay, and then the second one is to strengthen your branding lah. Okay, the third one is to increase sales. Okay, so marketing is about to introduce your branding, okay, to strengthen your brand and then to increase sales lah. For example, like McDonald's, I think most of you know what is McDonald's, KFC, okay, Nike, Adidas. So the most of the marketing is they introduce a new brand. Okay, so when they are launching a new for example like Adidas, they are launching a new shoes, so they will introduce the brand first. Okay, so this is the three element of marketing. Okay, so this is the flow of analysis of the product and service. So remember, you have already your ideas. Okay, after you have your idea, now we focus on the segmentation. Segmentation means the target market. Okay, the target market of your customer. Either you can satisfy your customer need or not. Okay, after that, you know who is your target market, then you can validate the product and service. Okay, and your product either can be owned, okay, either can be owned or affordable. Okay, people can buy or not. Okay, expensive or not less expensive. Okay, so from these four elements comes to marketing mix. Okay, this is where you communications to the customer. Okay, you give awareness about the existing of your product. Okay, so this we call it marketing mix. Okay, to communicate to customer. Okay, about the existing of your product or services. So this is the marketing segmentation. So the first is demographic. So demographic is you focus on age or gender lah. Okay. So for example, like you are selling tudung, okay, the tudung for Muslim wear, so you need to know who is the age for your suitable target market. Okay, of course women, and then your tudung is you need to focus on which age, okay, teenager or adult. Okay, and then the second one is socioeconomic. This one is based on their income. Okay, what is their income level? Okay, that's why you can buy tudung in a low, cheaper price or higher price. Okay, you need to know the education level also. You need to know the income level. Okay, and then the locations where you want to sell your locations. Okay, so during this pandemic, where is the location you sell your product? Okay, for example, like 1B. So when the 1B open the location at I think most of you know, so the target market is for UMS student, UiTM student. Okay, some alam mesra lah. So that is the locations. You need to know where is the location of your product, where you place it. And then the other one is psychological. Okay, this is based on the lifestyle lah. Okay, and then value. Okay, for example, like lifestyle, maybe people like new fashions. Okay, new fashion, new clothes. That's why entrepreneur created a boutique, okay, to sell clothes that is very unique and fashionable. Okay, so based on psychology, you can know your target market based on these four elements. Okay, so focus on which element that you need to target based on marketing segmentations. Okay, so this is the marketing mix lah. So remember, this always come out during the quiz. So the first is product, price, promotion, and place. So this is the most significantly we use. Okay, the basic one. This is just addition. Okay, so we have physical evidence, people, and process. So make sure when you do the marketing mix, okay, so of course the product, what is your USB, the uniqueness of your product, the branding, the packaging, okay, the first impressions to sell your product is the packaging and the branding, okay, and then the other one is the price. Okay, you need to know the price of your product, either do you have any discount. Okay, so the promotion is either online or offline channel lah. Okay, it's based on your social media, okay, and place, where are the place that you distribute your business. Okay, the distribution channel, the product placement, distribution source. Okay, later I will give you example here. Okay, so the other one is physical evidence lah. Okay, so you need to know that the physical evidence, and then you need to people to market your product, okay, and then the process, okay, how the process you deliver the product. So this is first element of marketing mix. Okay, first is product. So like McDonald's, what is the product? Breakfast, Happy Meal, McCafe, dessert, drink. Okay, some meeting. So you need to know what is your product. Okay, your business product during the SAPK. So you need to know this thing. Okay, and then the other one is your branding lah. So branding is a process to create a unique and persistent perceptions and experience in the mind of your user. So you need to know, the brand name of your company, and then the logo of your company. When people look at your logo, people know already what kind of business that you do. For example, like the M, the golden M word. Okay, I think most of you know what is the McDonald's. And then the other one is slogan. Okay, the slogan, your tagline, and then your color. I think most of the successful branding, they only use two or three color, okay, to justify their branding. So you need to know this one lah. So branding, they will come up, always come out during the quiz. So remember the brand name, what is the logo, slogan, and color. So this is the branding about your business. Okay, so this is the example of the brand, like yellow color, McDonald's, Nikon, okay, light, Starbucks, okay, peaceful. So you need to know the color. Okay, for example like KFC, okay, Coca-Cola. So this, the color is more on excellent if you use red color. So you need to know this color, choose the color that is suitable for your business. Okay, like this one. And then pricing. Okay, you need to know pricing. Okay, bundling pricing or psychology pricing. Okay, for example like this one lah. Okay, so this is a psychology pricing lah. In case it's just one ringgit, but you can make it like this one lah. It's a psychology pricing. Okay, so bundling pricing is like a combo lah. Okay, you give discount where McDonald's provide this meal lah. Okay, it's a combo meal. Okay, so you need to give bundling pricing on this one lah. Okay, so place. Okay, where is the place where you sell your product? For example, like McDonald's, they have their own restaurant, they have their online and deliver, and then some drive through, and then kiosk lah. So this is the placement for McDonald's. Okay, so promotions. Okay, so promotion either can be a TV, smartphone. Okay, promotion is usually on social media lah, like Facebook, Instagram. Okay, everything. Sometimes they put in the billboard. Okay, and then some they are selling sales promotion lah. That is for marketing mix. Okay. So this is the unique selling propositions. Okay, so I think most of you know what it says, unique selling propositions. So it is a direct. For direct means the material, the uniqueness of your product, the content of the product. Okay, either you have a serum qualifications. Okay. Indirect is the product uses. How you teach the customer how the product is used, how you use your product. Okay, you need to do some warranty, additional service. Okay. So that is the unique selling proposition, a factor that differentiate your product and service from its competitor. Yeah. So remember this one. So this is the example of product and service lah. Okay. So for product is based on testimonial. You need to do some testimonial, and service also testimonial lah. Okay. So this is the example.